This week's Ask Dr. Durie is a question from actually a large number of patients who want to know which vaccine for COVID-19 should they take. Right now, there are 6 vaccines available, of which 3 are available in the United States. The 3 that are available in the United States are the Pfizer and the Moderna. And then there's also what's called a vector vaccine with the spike protein, the J&J vaccine. Outside of the U.S., there's the AstraZeneca, and then also the Sputnik V vaccine, all vector vaccines. And then the 6th vaccine is the Sinopharm, which is an inactivated virus vaccine, which comes from China. Actually, the Sputnik V vaccine is also manufactured in China. For now, it's strongly recommended that, if possible, patients try to receive either the Pfizer or the Moderna vaccines, which have the highest efficacy benefit and really have had the least indications of any toxicities. Unfortunately, we have seen some extra toxicities with the vector vaccines. The J&J and the AstraZeneca have both had indications of a rare risk of blood clot problems, particularly for younger women under the age of 50. The big picture is, though, that if you have a chance to get vaccinated, you should obviously do it with due caution, but go ahead and get whichever vaccine is available to you. We know that in the main areas of benefit, which is hospitalization and the risk that you might die from a COVID-19 infection, all of the vaccines do a fantastic job in that regard. The level of efficacy in terms of an infection and spreading the infection is a little bit less with the Sputnik V and the Sinopharm vaccines, for example. The additional point for myeloma patients is that we are waiting to see if a booster will be necessary and what type of booster might be required. It seems that in myeloma patients, the antibody response and the immune T cell response is less than we might want to see. And so there quite probably will be a recommendation for an additional booster shot, maybe later this year or maybe early next year. What will that look like? We need to wait and see. Will it be just a repeat of the Pfizer or Moderna, or will it be a new one of those tailored to cover the new variants that have been popping up, particularly from Brazil and from the UK, and here now more recently, possibly from India? And so the bottom line is go ahead and get vaccinated with whatever is available to you, with a preference for the Pfizer or the Moderna, and be alert to the possible need for a booster later this year or early next year.